Hello everyone, I am Neha Ghazi from Leelavati Lal Jidyal High School and College of Commerce. In our English drama lesson today, we are going to talk about direct and indirect speech. So let us begin. Direct speech is a report of the exact words used by a speaker or writer. The words spoken appear within inverted commas. So whatever a person has said, when we are exactly quoting his or her words, that's when we say it's a direct speech, and it is normally in inverted commas. This, as you can see on your screen, students. So when we report what someone said in our own words, it is called indirect speech. We do not use inverted commas for it. So that is where we say it is an indirect speech or a reported speech, when we are actually, you know, reporting what the other person has said in our own words. All right, and here we will not use any inverted commas. So that was our direct and indirect speech. Okay, so let's see certain rules which we have to use. So use the words exclaimed, requested, ordered, asked, warned, thanked, advised, suggested, wished, greeted. So when we are converting, we have to keep these words in our mind. Use that or to in place of inverted commas. Mostly we use the word that. In case of a question, use the words if or whether. If the reported verb is in the present or future tense, the tense of the answer will not change. See this, students, if the reported verb is in the present or future tense, so the tense of the answer will not change. For example, she says. Now says is our reported verb and it is in the present tense. So here, reported speech, the tense of the reported speech will not change. All right, I am happy to be here this evening. So we have converted to she says that she is happy to be here this evening. All right, we didn't say she was happy. We said she is happy. Okay, we're not changing the tense. Why? Because our reported verb is in the present tense. If this would have been in the past tense, then too we would not change the tense of our reported speech. All right, let us see how do we have to convert it now in terms of our tenses. So if it is present simple, we will change it to past simple. All your present gets converted to all your past. Okay, that's what you have to keep in mind. So see here, he said, I work in a factory. He said that he worked in a factory. All right, simple present, but converted to simple past. And why did we change it? Because see here, said is in the past tense. Only then we change the tense of our reported speech. Then present continuous changed into past continuous. Shravan said, I am not going to school. So Shravan said that he was not going to school. Then we have present perfect. It gets converted to past perfect. Arvind said, I have won a prize. Arvind said that he had won a prize. Then we have present perfect continuous, which changes into past perfect continuous. So Neeta said, Nirma has been waiting for her sisters for 2 hours. Neeta said that Nirma had been waiting for her sisters for 2 hours. So for this, students, you'll have to remember the structure of your tenses also properly. All right. So that was about all our present getting converted to all our past. Now let us see the next one, that is simple past, which changes into past perfect. See here, Meena said, I bought a new car. Meena said that she had bought a new car. So our simple past got converted to our past perfect. Then we have past continuous, which gets converted to past perfect continuous. Pinky said, I was writing a poem. Pinky said that she had been writing a poem. So we converted our past continuous to past perfect continuous. See, had been writing past perfect continuous. Then we have past perfect, which changes into past perfect, which means there is no change at all. So Aisha said, I had not received the letter. Aisha said that she had not received the letter. So we did not change anything in this. Past perfect remains past perfect. There is absolutely no change in it. Let us see the next one now. The last two that we have. So future. Your will changes into would. He said, I will go to London. He said that he would go to London. Then here we have in future continuous, will be changes into would be. He said to me, I will be waiting for you. He said to me that he will be waiting for me. Let us see some more examples. Okay, before that we will see how our words will be converted. So I becomes he or she, now becomes them, here becomes there, ago becomes before, today becomes that day, tomorrow becomes next day, yesterday becomes day before, can becomes could, shall becomes should, will becomes would, you becomes he or she depending, these becomes those, me becomes him or her again depending on the subject, we becomes they, our becomes their, us becomes them, and my becomes his or her. So this is how we are going to convert our words. All right. So let us see some more examples. She said, my teacher is writing letters. So here we can see our reported verb is in the past tense, which means the tense of our reported speech will also change. Is writing will become was writing, correct? So she said that her teacher was writing letters. We have seen this in the rules of conversion. The doctor said to the patient, give up smoking. So now this is an advice. So we have used the word advice rather than writing said. So the doctor advised patient to give up smoking. We are not using the word that here. All right. In our rules, in the first rule page itself, we have seen we either use that or we use the word to. So here to is applicable. The doctor advised the patient to give up smoking. Let's see the third example now. He said, be quiet and listen to my words. So now obviously this is an order or a command. So we will use the word ordered. He ordered them to be quiet and listen to his words. See, my word became his words. We saw this in conversion table, right? So that's all students in our direct and indirect speech. If you remember the rules properly of conversion, you will be good to go with this topic. Thank you so much.